Hello students, today we'll see how to read pH chart, a very important topic. So first understand the different lines on pH chart. So this is your critical point. So this is saturated liquid line, this is saturated vapor line, correct? This is vapor dome, this is subcooled region, and this will be a superheated region. The most important line on pH chart is constant temperature line. So constant temperature lines will be, suppose I am following now minus 30 degree centigrade line. So this line will go here and it will be downward. So this is constant temperature line. Similarly, we follow suppose 0 degree centigrade line. This is constant temperature line. So please understand this constant temperature lines. After constant temperature line, constant entropy line is also very important. So this S is equal to 2.6, 2.5, this is constant entropy line. Suppose we follow constant entropy line. So this is constant entropy line. So this constant temperature line and constant entropy line, these two lines are most important. As this is a pressure, so pressure lines will be straight horizontal. Now this is enthalpy, so enthalpy lines will be straight vertical. This temperature, if temperature is in vapor dome, it is saturated, this is condenser temperature and this will be evaporator temperature. So let us understand this pH diagram from numerical itself. So this is the numerical which we want to solve. So in this numerical, condenser temperature is given 40 degree centigrade, evaporator temperature minus 30 degree centigrade. Degree of superheat and degree of supercooling is also given. So from this we have to calculate COP, and compression is given isentropic, which is very normal, where in every numerical compression is almost isentropic. So in numerical they may give you condenser pressure also instead of temperature. So condenser pressure corresponding to 40 degree centigrade will be 10 bar, and evaporator temperature is minus 30. So evaporator pressure corresponding to minus 30 will be 1 bar, and we have to use R12 as a refrigerant. So we have to use pH chart of R12. Now this is carbon dioxide, so we have to use R12. So this is R12 refrigerant, correct? This is R12 refrigerant. So we have to plot this point. Now first given data is, we have to plot condenser temperature line, that is at minus 40 degree centigrade. So 40, this is 30, 40, 50. So 40 temperature, this is condenser temperature line. Also corresponding to 40 degree centigrade, pressure is 10 bar. So this is 10 bar, it is in megapascal now. So 10 bar is equal to 1 megapascal. So at 1 megapascal, draw constant pressure line, which is condenser pressure. Similarly, evaporator temperature is given minus 30 degree centigrade. So this is minus 20, minus 30, this is minus 40. So this will be a minus 30 degree centigrade. Corresponding to this, pressure is 0.1 bar. So draw constant pressure line. So this will be evaporator pressure. Now two pressure lines are given. Now we have to plot 0.1, and for 0.1, degree of superheat is given. Degree of superheat is 10 degree centigrade. Degree of superheat means it is a delta T from minus evaporator temperature minus superheated, the after evaporator temperature. So evaporator temperature is minus 30 and degree of superheat is 10. So T1 will be is equal to minus 30 minus 10, sorry, minus 30 plus 10, it will be minus 20 degree centigrade. So plot T1 of minus 20 degree centigrade, and to plot minus this H1, to plot 0.1, follow temperature line of minus 20, because T1 temperature is minus 20. So minus 20 temperature line. Now this is minus 20. So minus temperature 20 line will be like this, go like this, it will be going downward now. So whenever this constant temperature line and this pressure line crosses, that will be your 0.1, correct? So this will be 0.1. Now, as we know that compression is given, that is isentropic process. Isentropic means constant entropy. So follow constant entropy line from point 1. Now, we know that constant entropy lines are like this. So follow constant entropy line from point 1. So from point 1, constant entropy lines will be like this. So whenever this constant entropy line and this condenser pressure line crosses, that will be point 2. So this is point 1, this is point 2. Now we have to plot point 3. Point 3, degree of subcooling is given. Degree of subcooling is 10 degree centigrade. Degree of subcooling means condenser temperature minus there will be a 10 degree decrease in temperature after condensation process. So this is 40 degree centigrade. So T3 temperature will be 30 degree centigrade. That is 40 minus this degree of subcooling 10. So 30 degree centigrade. So follow temperature line of 30 degree centigrade. So this is 30 degree centigrade temperature line. It will go upward, again downward. But this temperature line is corresponding to the condenser pressure. Therefore, whenever this condenser pressure line and this 30 degree centigrade line crosses, that will be point 3. Now this is point 3. Correct? This one. Now as we know that 3 to 4 is an expansion process. Expansion process is generally considered as an isenthalpic process. So enthalpy will be constant. This will be point 4. Now this is the actual cycle of H1 vapor compression cycle. H1, H2, H3 and H4 we have to calculate now. As we know that enthalpy is on the x-axis, so to calculate enthalpy, go straight downward vertical line. That will be enthalpies of corresponding point. Now we have to calculate, suppose H1. Now H1 will be enthalpy corresponding to this pressure. Now this line will go downward, correct? It is close to the, or it is exactly on the value 350. So H1 will be 350. Similarly S2, now we have to plot point for S2. This is H2, go upward, it will be somewhere here. It is 350, 360, 70, 80, 385. It is between 380 and 390, correct? So it will be 385. So S2 will be 385, correct? Now H3, we have to calculate H3 now. Now S3 and H4 are straight line. It is isenthalpic process. Enthalpy is constant. So S3 is equal to H4. If you go upward, this enthalpy line will be here. Now this is 200, 210, 20, 30. So it will be 230. So H3 is 230. As we know that this enthalpy 3 to 4, it is a process constant, enthalpy process. So H4 is equal to H3. Now calculate COP. Now COP will be a simple refrigerating effect divided by compressor work. Refrigerating effect is H1. Now in this case, this is refrigerating effect and this will be compressor power, and this total will be heat rejected by condenser, correct? Total, because condensation part will be 3 to 2. Now refrigerating effect divided by compressor work, it is COP. So refrigerating effect is H1 minus H4 divided by compressor work, H2 minus H1. Now by using simple calculations, H1 is 350 minus H4 230 divided by H2 385 minus H1, that is 350. This will be 3.4. So COP is equal to 3.4. I hope you understand how to read pH diagram. only important is temperature lines and constant entropy lines. So this temperature lines which are going downward and entropy lines. Okay, thank you for watching this video.